I'm so glad it's almost over. Congratulations, sweetie.
Thank you.
I'll never understand why you chose such a macabre field.
There's nothing disturbing about it. It's just
but
that
I'm proud of you. I really am. You've come so far. So, you haven't told me what's next. Will you get a job where you are, or...?
They actually have everyone they need. But my old teacher, Mr. Delver, transferred me to his office to finalize my internship there.
Oh, well, that's good. I remember you mentioning him. Where's he located? Are you moving away from me?
No, I'm not moving. He's actually located around here. River Fields.
Oh, Rebecca. I don't like that.
Grandma.
Even I've heard things about that place. I'd just be worried
people
about you.
People make up stories. Death is a scary thing to a lot of people. And we try to explain things we don't understand, and we want comfort when we lose someone we love. I mean, no one's embalming any ghost bodies or whatever. It's fine.
Right. I'm sorry. But I wanted to give you this anyway. So, here.
I don't know if I want that.
Just take it, please. It should be yours anyway.
Thanks.
All right, enough spooky stuff. I'm so proud of you. When is all this happening? When do you start?
I've actually been there for a few weeks now. My review is tomorrow. Here we go.
Rebecca, great, perfect timing. I just finished with Mr. Dalton here. Please wheel him back to cold storage and bring us Mrs. Page. Alright, I'm just finishing up something here, so why don't you grab the clipboard and start recording identifying marks. I'll get out of your way when you're done and let you hop in here. These old windows never stay latched. Great. Climb on in here and put everything into the record system. Don't forget to take the printout to the front desk so Zoe can add it to the packet for the family. After that, we'll get started. You'll die here.
What was that?
I didn't say anything. You all right?
Yeah, I'm fine. Sorry. Time to embalm.
All right. I've set everything out so you can just go ahead and get started. I'll be monitoring. Everything's on your list there if you need it.
There we go. All right.
Sometimes we get chemicals that haven't been stored properly, and it can make them pop like that. Just keep doing your thing. I'll get it.
There we go.
Tell you what.
What?
Why don't you go ahead and head out? I'll take over from here.
Are you sure? I just got here.
Don't worry. You're doing great. I'll get the last of your paperwork sorted today and call you in for your first shift.
It was just really weird.
So some stuff fell over. That's not a big deal.
No, I know. It wasn't even my fault, but he sent me home right after that. I'm just really worried. He was supposed to finalize my stuff today.
And he said he would, right?
Yeah.
So that's a good thing.
Yeah, it just didn't feel like he meant it. Like, he just said it to get me out of the building. Wait a sec, I have another call. Hello?
Hey, Rebecca. It's Raymond.
Oh, hi, Mr. Delver. Look, if I did anything wrong today, just...
No. I wanted to apologize. You've done a fantastic job. I'm just not feeling too well. That's actually why I'm calling. I know it's late, but we just got 3 new cadavers, and no one else can make it in right now. I was hoping you could come in and take care of them.
Well, yeah. Are you sure? I mean, of course.
Excellent. You're doing me a huge favor. I took care of the rest of your onboarding. We're all set. And your new badge is in your personal belongings drawer in the back room.
That's great. Thank you. I'm on my way right now. I hope you feel better.
Thanks again. I'll see you tomorrow.
Bye. Holy shit! That was him. He signed me on. He needs me to come in tonight.
See? I told you it was fine. Congratulations.
Thanks. I have to go, like, right now. I'll talk to you later. Where are my keys? All right, guess I'll head to the back and get started.
Rebecca.
Mr. Delver! I need help. Someone's outside the mortuary.
Just try to stay calm. I know you're scared. I'll unlock the door in a moment.
What?
This is very sudden, but listen to me. We have to start right away. I'm sorry. I didn't know until it made itself known this morning that it was here, let alone bound to you. I had no way of knowing the possession had started.
What? Look, this isn't funny. Stop.
You need to take this seriously. You need to act quickly.
This is insane. I'll just leave. I'll just fucking leave.
You can't leave, Rebecca. I can't allow that for you or for others. It's far too dangerous.
What am I supposed to do then?
Most bodies I work with at night are fine. So we stay calm, okay? We embalm, file the paperwork, everything. Treat it like a normal day. Staying focused will help. I left some things for you on the desk. I'll call again when you get to the embalming room.
No, wait. Ugh, damn it, what the fuck? This is insane. Okay. This is so stupid. Just some hazing for the new girl or something. Just play along and do your job. Quitting tomorrow. I mean, who does something like this?
All right, listen carefully.
I'm sorry, but this entire thing is extremely unprofessional. If this is how you treat new hires, I don't think I can work for you. This isn't funny.
Rebecca, you don't have to believe me. But I hope you do before it's too late. The only way to save yourself is to banish the demon before you're too far gone. To do that, you will need to learn the demon's name, bind it to its chosen body, and burn it in the retort. Look, I know this is a lot to take in. I wish I could do more for you. I had years to learn what I know. You have hours. I've recorded a number of cassettes to instruct you, in the hope that having a physical object with a known message will help you stay grounded. I won't be calling again. You can't trust the phones. Anything can be manipulated. Listen to the tapes. Learn the demon's name. Burn the correct body. The most important thing in the room is in that cabinet. Open it up. Good luck, Rebecca. I'm sorry this had to happen.
This is insane. Whatever. Just be the professional one, grab a body, and get started. Yeah, screw all of whatever this is. I'm getting back to work.
The night shift database. A computer program combining all my findings
just
into one
grab a body
point.
And get started.
The database contains all the information on the process of expulsion, the tools used, and most importantly, all the markings of the known demonic names. If you ever forget what to do, replay these tapes or look it up in the database. The collection of demonic names is the most crucial piece to the puzzle. You will need this information. My ID card is in my personal belongings drawer. On the back is the passcode to access it. Use it. At every moment, the demon is funneling its energy through you, weakening you, until you are unable to resist. Identifying a demonic entity is a delicate balance. The further you are from possession, the more time you have.
The
closer you are, the more the demon will make itself known, allowing you the information. justice. Look carefully. If you notice anything strange, it's starting to take hold. There's a notepad and a pencil on the desk in the front room. Checking from time to time can give an idea of how long you might have.
All right, let's check you out. I can keep track of things.
To banish a demon to hell, it must be bound to its chosen body and burned. The three objects in this cabinet are your tools. First, the clay tablet in the center is called a mark. Placing the smaller pieces in the...
Hello? New job. I'm getting out of here. Okay, how long I went to school? You clear. Screw this. I'm getting back to work. So stupid. There we go. I need to file the copy up front. Time to embalm. There we go. Right. Thank you.
your eyes open, and your last vision as they wither will be of the flesh being peeled from your legs, and all that will be left is eternal pain and darkness. You will beg me to take your pathetic carcass.
If you notice anything strange, it's starting to take hold.
Jesus Christ.
To banish a demon to hell, it must be bound to its chosen body and burned. The three objects in this cabinet are your tools.
All right.
First,
this
clay tablet
working?
In the center is called a mark.
Yeah.
Placing
huge.
The smaller pieces in the configuration
so,
will spell the demon's name.
I guess.
Second,
this is David.
Bottles on the top shelf are
Raymond.
A special reagent that will react to the mark. Add a bottle to the embalming mixture during the process. When the mark is placed on the correct body with the reagent inside, it will force the demon to become bound to it. Pay attention to signs that you have chosen correctly. They can be obvious or extremely subtle. Once you are certain the demon is bound to its vessel, burn it. Finally, the pieces of paper on the right are called letting strips. It must inscribe the sigils of its name in our world to begin the evocation. You will need to uncover these sigils to use them. Hold a letting strip up while wandering the mortuary. If it begins to smolder and burn, you're close. When the paper combusts, the sigil has been revealed somewhere in that area. They can be anywhere. So look on walls, under objects, inside furniture. Anywhere. The demon will inscribe its sigils over time to try and hide them, so check regularly. Once you uncover the sigils, use the night shift database to decide which demon you're dealing with, and use that knowledge to create the mark. The steps are simple. Add the reagent to the embalming mixture. Uncover the sigils. Build the mark and place it on the body. Then, when you're certain, burn it in the retort.
There we go. I can't use that here. All right,
the dead comfort you.
There we go. What is
this?
What?
Thank you.
All right. Sure.
What are you doing here?
There we go. can't use that here.
Are you sure this is the right one?
Can I leave? I want to go home.
You can leave. But once an entity finds you, all the houses of hell will do anything to get back to you. I'm sorry, but it doesn't end here. From now on, there is always a chance this will happen again, no matter where you are.
I don't want this. I just want to leave. What do I do?
I'm sorry, but there's no going back. I've spent years learning everything I can to keep these entities at bay. It's the only thing we can do.
So what? You're waging some selfless, holy war?
It's not a war. It's survival. And I'd hardly call it selfless. We're caught at the front line of something larger. But I don't do this for some greater good. We either face it or fall to it. I wish I could claim to be someone better. Suffering hell to save us all. But I simply want to live another day, just like everyone else. When I first experienced this, I had to make a choice. I could run and spend the rest of my days in fear, or I could learn to face it and keep some semblance of a normal life.
Normal. Right.
It's not a life I would want for anyone, but choosing between a life of fear or control. You're the first person I've met to face this hell and survive. So I'm offering you a different kind of job. Work the night shift. Learn what I know. Give yourself a chance at a life beyond fear. I don't know what you experienced, but I know it uses the worst parts of you against yourself. The more you experience, the more you'll confront the darkest parts of your life. But through it, you'll become unbreakable. I'm offering the tools to take control. The choice is yours. I hope you come back.
At least I can keep track of things. Mr. Delver? At least I can keep track of things. There we go. There we go. All right. I'm missing something. There we go. Will you help me? All right. Thank you. There we go. I already have one of those. There we go.
Did this to me.
Are you sure this is the right one?
All right. There we go. All right.
It's nice not to be the one down there for a change.
Mr. Dover?
I think you can just call me Raymond at this point.
Do you always just pass out and wake up on the floor?
It takes a lot out of you. I've never simply walked out of here after. You get used to it.
I'll be sure to clean the floors better. Raymond, will this ever end?
I honestly don't know. I've been doing this a long time, Rebecca. I've traveled all over, learning everything I can. I've never found anything that could put a stop to it. So no, I don't think it does.
So, we're just like this forever?
It was hard for me too. But this is the life we get. We have to face our worst selves, constantly. But the better we know ourselves, the stronger we are. Why don't you head home? Get some rest. Who knows what's coming tonight?
Love you, Dad. At least I can keep track of things. There we go. There we go. Right. There we go.
Why did you let me die? your fault. I regret every second with you. Time is running out, Rebecca.
Already died, Kiwi.
There we go. There we go. Right. No?
Hello? I need to report a missing person. Sorry. Her name is Rebecca Owens. She's 14. She has a drug problem.
So I have that crazy. So we should...
I don't know. She was here, at the house.
Slit your wrist.
I understand that. I need you to check them. All right. All right. I'll keep an eye out. Thank you.
Hello? I need to report a missing person. She has a drug problem.
Rebecca! Rebecca!
Rebecca!
No. Just hold it, baby. No. Oh my god. Fuck. Okay, baby, don't worry. It's okay. I'll get you out of here.
Please, sir. I'll just right up there. I'm coming back. I'm coming right back.
Hey! I found her! Down here!
I can't use that here. I'm missing something.
Are you sure this is the right one?
All right.
Hey,
There we go. There we go. All right. I miss you so much. I don't care about anything anymore. I don't want to be here without you. Please, just... I love you.
should have died when you had the chance.
I can't use that here. I can't use that here. There we go. Right.
Way. It's nice not to be the one down there for a change. Why don't you head home? Get some rest. Who knows what's coming tonight?
Love you, Dad. Keep track of things. There we go. There we go. All right. Can't hold anything else. There we go. Right. Thank you.
Rebecca? Get over to Grandma.
Mom. You stupid bitch. Hate me all you want. He's dead because of you.
You should be the one here.
Lifeless. Worthless.
It's me.
There we go.
Are you sure this is the right one?
Thank you. There we go. All right. There we go. Thank you. I can't use that here.
Hey, little love.
Dad?
I'm here. It's all right. You're safe.
Oh my God, Dad.
Hey, sweetie, it's all right.
I ruined everything.
No. My little girl, don't do this to yourself. You've suffered enough.
Mom.
You're not like her, Rebecca. Your mother, she gave up on life long before she died. What happened to me was the result of choices you should have never been exposed to. You changed your life. And I'm so proud of you.
You changed too.
Not before I heard you. Sweetie, you can't do this to yourself. Don't remember me like this.
I don't want to forget you.
If you relive that night over and over, you'll only remember pain. The best of me is in you, sweetie. I'm with you forever.
I just miss you so much. Every day I don't know where to go without you.
Shh, I know. I know it's hard. But you know where to go. You've already found it. Souls are suffering, Rebecca. But you can help them. You can bring comfort and closure to the living. And let the dead rest. Let the dead rest, Rebecca. I love you.
Dad. I love you.
Thank you.
sure this is the right one?
What happened? Let me go! Hey! What are you doing?
Sorry. This is the only way.
No, no! Why are you doing this? Help me, please! Raymond! 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 Hiding.
Burn!
You can never
fix what you've done!
At least I can keep track of things. There we go. There we go. There we go. Thank you. There we go.
Rebecca, come here.
Mom. You stupid bitch.
Hate me all you want. He's dead because of you.
You should be the one here.
Lifeless.
It's me.
Thank you. There we go. Right.
Thank you.
There we go. I can't use that here.
The door is open.
There we go. All right. I can't use that here. I can't use that here. I can't use that here. There we go. Right. use that here. That's not it.
Said already that I've had to accept everything about myself, just like you do. This is a necessary evil.
It's sick! She's down there, right now, just suffering for no reason!
Valerie is not down there. Not anymore. She's been gone for years.
You don't know that! You're just gonna let her stay there! You don't know what she's feeling. You are torturing her!
She's helping me survive. She's helping us survive. Without her, there's no reagent. Without the reagent, we have nothing. You want to have a chance at life? It comes with a cost. This cost. You have to make a choice, just like I did.
What choice? Keep her alive to just bleed her over and over again to save ourselves? If she can't be saved, end the torture. I mean, she's down there suffering for your own gain.
My gain? My gain. You used her too. It didn't stop you from finishing the job. You used her blood anyway. When it came down to it, you chose survival, just like I did. I can't kill her, Rebecca. I know it's the right thing to do for her. I know. But she isn't the only one.
What?
I've seen many experience what you did. None have survived. I've watched them degrade and suffer until they're no longer themselves. I didn't know what else to do. I couldn't just let them suffer. I searched for years to find a way to reverse it. all I found was the way to prevent more. Isn't that better than nothing? I've killed them all, Rebecca. It was the only thing I could do. So yes, I am a monster. But this one horrible thing has prevented me from having to take any more life. And I would choose that again and again. I can't live with any more death than I already do. I've made peace with it. The choice is yours if you can too. I'll see you tomorrow.
Love you, Dad.
At least I can keep track of things. There we go. Hello?
Hello. Rebecca? Rebecca?
What the? There we go. All right.
Why didn't you let me die? This is all your fault.
There we go. Right. There we go. There we go. Right. Rebecca.
Sure, this is the right one.
There we go. Right.
It's nice not to be the one down there for a change.
Raymond?
I suppose a first name basis is in order.
Did I make it? Is it over?
For now. It's never really over. You've come a long way. It's a lot to learn.
I'm so glad I'm here.
I know it's disorienting. You'll get used to it. You should head home and get some rest. Every night can be different.
I think I'm fine.
Are you sure? You seem out of it.
Oh, I've just been waiting for so, so long.
What? What are you... Oh, no. You chose the wrong demon. Rebecca!
Rebecca's not here, you fucking idiot!
I will consume your soul. Watch your foolish boy. And drink it as it melts from your pitiful frame! Worthless old shit!
Love you, Dad.
Hey, little love.
Dad?
I'm here. It's all right. You're safe.
Oh my God, Dad.
Hey, sweetie, it's all right. No. My little girl, don't do this to yourself. You've suffered enough.
If I hadn't been like Mom...
You're not like her, Rebecca. Your mother... She gave up on life long before she died. What happened to me was the result of choices you should have never been exposed to. You changed your life. And I'm so proud of you.
You changed too.
Not before I heard you. Sweetie, you can't do this to yourself. Don't remember me like this.
I don't want to forget you.
If you relive that night over and over, you'll only remember pain. The best of me is in you, sweetie. I'm with you forever.
I just miss you so much. Every day I don't know where to go without you.
Shh, I know. I know it's hard. But you know where to go. You've already found it. Souls are suffering, Rebecca. But you can help them. You can bring comfort and closure to the living. And let the dead rest. Let the dead rest, Rebecca. I love you.
Dad. I love you.